Hey guys, it's Kevin. Last year, have a ET-8550 that has the ink leaking. So today, let's understand what's going on. You have this oval metal mesh. That's where the ink goes into. The metal mesh is a little bit higher than the surrounding. And surrounded, you can see this larger oval. So this is hard plastic. You can see I can scratch it with my tweezers. Remember, this is hard. Then, surrounded by this hard surface, there is a larger oval. That's the rubber seal. Now, if we take a damper, the damper is going to include the hard surface inside, and the leather rubber seal touch this really large circle, and you can see it's a little bit sketchy. It's so thin, that's why you may have leaks. For example, you may have some imperfection on the seal, or when you put it in, your damper is not setting flat on the hard surface. So the hard surface is a little bit tilted, and so you have a gap. That's where the ink leak comes from. To prevent it, you can practice how to set the damper flat, or you can put some silicone washer around it. Today, I'll be going to show you how to install the silicone washer.
Hey everyone, it's Abby here. We're going to show you how to put some silicone pads into the ET-8550. They sit on top of the printhead, and this should help ink from leaking into the printhead, which would get ink onto your FFC cables. It can destroy your printhead, which also would possibly burn your FFC cables, and that could give you a 031006 error. Also would burn into your main board, so that would just bring up a lot of errors. Also having to make you buy another printhead, which can be pretty expensive. I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do that right now. We are detaching the ink tubes from the dampers on the ET-8550 printer, and I've undone the plastic cover on the ink tubes, taken off the two screws on there, and detached the spring.
I just want to mention that Abby is working on the empty dampers. So if your dampers already has ink in them, you'll need to take the ink out. To take it out, you can park the carriage, return at the capping station, and then you can draw the ink out from sucking from the waste tubes that will suck the ink out and empty your damper. Okay, back to you, Abby.
Now I'm taking out the six screws that hold the dampers in place. They go to the metal brackets that are with the dampers. I'm using a pair of tweezers when I am taking out my screws. It helps me not lose them. Also, these screws are not magnetic, so my drill is not just going to pull it out itself. So hold on to these small screws. Don't lose them. You'll need them when you put the dampers back in. I'm taking the dampers out with the brackets. Also, don't lose the brackets. You'll need them.
If you do lose your screws or brackets, there's only one place in the whole world that you can find them. It's called bchtechnologies.com. So you go to bchtechnologies.com and type in ET-8550. And here's damper, here's bracket, and here's the screws. The screws is also can be used for L1800 and 1390, and they sell them in a pack of three pieces. So if you lose all six of them, you gotta get an order two of those.
As you see, when I take out the dampers, I hold on to the damper a little bit, or the bracket in front, and I pull it towards me, and that releases the bracket from the back of the printhead. The last one I usually have a little trouble with, so you can take your tweezers, grab onto the bracket, and pull it out towards you, and that will release it in the back. Okie dokie, so these are the little silicone pads that Kevin has created. We'll take a closer look at it in a second, and we're going to place it on the color, and we want it to sit on top, not cover any area where the ink would flow through from the damper. We're going to pull it off, and we're going to inspect it to see that there's any loose scraps really in the middle. And if you do see that, you can just grab it with your fingers and pull it off. It will come off really easy. You don't have to worry about breaking the silicone ring. If you see it on the outside, you just pull it off like that with your fingers as well. It's very easy. All right, we got a really good up-close view. I want to show you that there's these two little notches on either side of the silicone ring. Okay, now look on each color of the printhead. You see a little notch on each side. That's where we want our silicone ring to line up. It's not going to click in any way, and obviously it's silicone, so it's not going to be like a plastic piece. But again, the silicone does not have to totally surround every part of it and fit down snug inside around every color inside the printhead.
What Abby said is, as long as you surround that hard oval plastic, as long as you surround it and push it down, it's not going to fall in anywhere. It just lay on the top. So what you focus on is the center, that you surround the center, then you just lay the washer on top.
But again, every time we put it in, we're going to want to look at the silicone ring, and then we are going to want to make sure that there's no little scrap pieces in the middle. I'm going to bring my hand back down in here, hopefully, or we'll see. Okay, so we see that there's nothing really in the middle, but those two notches, the one at the top, the one at the bottom, I want to try to get them lined up as close as I can. And I see that there's nothing in the middle blocking where that damper will sit back on top. Now, this is one way of doing it, right? Me placing them down in the printhead without the damper. Later, you're going to see when I place dampers back down into it, and I can also place these rings right onto the damper instead of the printhead. Really easy, again, to pull off those little scraps. You saw I did it with my fingers. If you want, you can try to pull it off with tweezers. I found it so much easier just to pull it off with my hands because I got a better grip than the tweezers did on the small little scrappy pieces. All right, this is a really simple way of doing it. I feel like I said, this is one way of just laying it down into the printhead. I'll talk about the other way where we can lay it onto the damper and then lay the dampers into the printhead. Okie dokie, so we have our dampers back and we still have our bracket on the damper. If we see on the back of the printhead in the ET-8550, there are small little slots in the back. That is where it's wanting you to put the tail of the damper, is what I'm going to call it, the tail of the damper into. And then the front of the damper where the screw hole goes, it wants you to fit it in there snug. That's where we go, and I might use my tweezers again to help me line it up, and then I just give it a little tug to make sure that the tail is actually into the back. This is the perfect spot where I wanted to talk about it. So do you see how my silicone ring fell off from when I needed to readjust my damper? Here's the other way of doing it. We can look at our actual dampers and flip them upside down, and we can apply the rings to the dampers themselves instead of the printhead, and then put the dampers like that onto a printhead that has no silicone rings on it already. I'm basically saying we're not going to put two silicone rings on there, right? I only worked a few dampers this way when I needed to readjust a damper and the silicone ring came out from the printhead with the damper. I just checked and I realigned that the silicone ring wasn't in the way from where the ink would flow. However you would prefer to do that is up to you, really. So here again, I'm just using my tweezers to line up. You don't have to hold the tweezers the whole time. It's really just so that the screws don't go everywhere, because so I've had sometimes where the screws fall into the printer and it may be hard to find them. And again, as I said, these screws are not magnetic, so it's not as easy for me just to stick a little magnet and hold it in my hand and try to reach around inside the printer. I don't want that to create a jam or give me another error. So that's why I'm being a little bit more careful with these screws. Yeah, I could just hold them in my hand, but that's why I'm being a little bit more precautious with this.
If you want to see a video dedicated to how to replace the dampers and how to install them, I'm going to put the link above.
And here I had another damper where I needed to readjust my bracket on it. Again, when I pulled it up, it pulled the silicone ring with it, which I feel is a good sign. Then it shows that there's some suction between the damper and the silicone ring. I just wanted to make sure again that before I put that damper back in, that the silicone ring was in the correct spot with the damper. So there's that. Putting in that last damper. And again, I said that one always seems to just be a little bit difficult, probably because it's pushed right up against the side of the printhead. So go ahead and get yourself a little tool to help you with that, and we'll make it much easier. Now that we have all our dampers back on, we are going to put our ink tubes back together. So this is again where we were in the very beginning, when we were detaching everything. Here's a thing that I'll also say: if you're having any trouble with trying to put your ink tubes back on, or your plastic guard right here, make sure that those ink tubes in the middle are flat down under the little tab. You see there's kind of one in the front, but there's also one, or one in the back a little bit, but there's also one in the front here under this little black guard where we'll put our black guard back that I've taken off. So again, we need to put our spring back on there. Right now we have the lever facing away. When we pull it closer to us, it will be easier to put this spring on. So try to get it on and pull it towards us and latch it on. And then we'll reattach our tubes. All right, everyone, we hope you enjoyed this video. For other helpful videos, you can go to youtube.com/BCH Technologies, or you can visit us at bchtechnologies.com or locally here in Greensboro, North Carolina. BCH.